exist, but I could never ever justify it. And I guess this channel as a hobby is my way of justifying it. And if it does, okay. If not, it starts to pay for itself, like it's over to spend and okay and pays for itself, then I'll probably up it to a 3-box subscription, or I might consider doing other boxes as well. I know this is the same company as Savvy. I don't have much faith in Savvy, but I like the premise, but I don't get on with their SES, their customer service, and the site in general. I find they're a pain in the ass, basically, but I know people have positive experiences with them. It's a shame, really, because if there's anybody out there who doesn't remember Play.com, I absolutely love Play.com. And Savvy could have just had that market by the balls, and fortunately, they don't treat their customers the way they should, I don't think, and their customer service is such copy-paste drivel. But, hey, other people have positive experiences with Savvy. I'm not one of them. So far, with Pop of the Box, I am reasonably happy. This is my first box, but I've bought a pop off there before. In fact, I've got 2 pre-orders that are supposed to be out this month and 8 to come, but I gather Pop in a Box and Savvy, they source their pops from many different warehouses, and they can take anywhere between 3 days to a month to arrive, which is why they can be a pain to chase up. But anyway, let's see if I manage to disappoint myself in my own choices. Shinies, like the golds or metallics, and the one-tone ones, I don't get that personally, but I think the black and white one, because I remember, I'm not old enough to remember, but I've been around long enough to have seen the old Disney characters back when it was Steamboat Willie and whatnot, and the old black and white Mickey. Photoshop to cut the videos together, because you know that's where it's at for video editing, Photoshop. So yeah, hey, I'm kind of cool, I'm digging them. I'm not sure, maybe I'll end up collecting all the Mickeys now because of this. I definitely put on the list. try and get a bit more cheeky and try the more tactical but bright vibe if I'm not getting anything, you know, too exciting. My biggest fear is I like the bombshells, and they're really cheap at the likes of B&M Bargains, and I've only got a couple, so I kind of put them on a list, and I feared they'd send them me when I could probably get them from like B&M or the Entertainer for half the price. But you know, these work out about £8 each when you buy a 2-box subscription, which is obviously cheaper than most places sell pops off the shelf. When you get a third, you actually have to pay for the shipping on the third as a free gift. So even as a free gift, you have to pay £3 shipping on that. Whereas on this one, you get a 2-box subscription with free shipping for about £18, I think. So it actually works out £9 each. And then you put this on top with the shipping. Something's telling me game actually it's £23, but it must have been less. I'm pretty sure it's only £3 shipping. But either way, I got 3 pops for the price of about £22-23. And yeah, so we'll have to see how it goes now. From here on in, every month, I'm going to obviously end up starting a pop collection. I already have about 8. And now I've started to collect ones that I wouldn't necessarily buy off the shelf. I guess I'm officially a pop collector. Yeah. But hey, at least I get to make videos and have a bit of fun and play about my studio and explore video instead of, you know, just stills all the time. I'm not even sure if I'm going to let people know about this channel yet that know me personally, because I've only been weird being on camera. But hey, speaking of my photography and being on camera, you'll probably see from the intro videos the little splash point references. That is my photography pages. So yeah, if you're wondering why the splash point reference that doesn't reference this YouTube channel, that is why. And everyone likes to talk about quality of boxes. I don't even want that soft, that's not even part of the box, it doesn't look damaged. Let's do that, why not? We're here. It has a few nicks. I've seen some disastrous pop in a box thingies, because I tend to watch. I watch a lot of ASMR and I watch a lot of unboxing. That's kind of what I do when it comes to YouTube. And I've seen some disastrous unboxings of pop in a box. You know, it's not brilliant. I know hardcore collectors would be really miffed at that, but you know, I'm not a massive hardcore collector. I do keep them in the boxes mostly. There are a couple that I have specifically for the studio, which is pops that are holding cameras, and they're going to be unboxed just to have as little. I suppose what they are, little toys, little statues just sitting around on the makeup desk and whatnot. But yeah, in general, the boxes aren't too bad. You know, that one's a bit squished, but hey. So yeah, I'm quite content with the black and white. And I suppose that's my first pop in a box. It's my birthday tomorrow. This video probably won't come out for another week or two, yeah, because I'm already backlogged behind 2 videos, I think, because I was waiting for a pop for so long with my mum's birthday about 2 weeks ago. So yeah, you probably won't see that, because I'm such a noob that no one will know my channel. But please do like, please do subscribe, and then, you know, check out previous videos.